The Davao Regional Police Chief in the Philippines is sacked as authorities probe an operation to serve an arrest warrant for fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. Former Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte says he will take legal action against police personnel who allegedly committed abuses during the operation. We have this report.
The Regional Police Director of Davao, Brigadier General Aligre Martinez, has been relieved from his post. This is in connection with the law enforcement operations on Monday to serve the arrest warrant on Pastor Apollo Quiboloy in several compounds of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. 12 personnel from the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group and Special Action Force were also relieved and transferred to PNP Calabarzon. Brigadier General Nicolas De Loso Torre of the PNP Communications and Electronic Service will replace Martinez. Torre resigned from the Quezon City Police District in September last year following criticisms of special treatment involving the road rage case of a dismissed gun-toting cop. Former President Duterte, who was named administrator of church properties of the religious group, plans to take legal action against the police officers. Senator Robin Padilla plans to file a resolution seeking a probe into the operation. Meanwhile, the Police Regional Office 11 filed charges against 6 persons for allegedly charging authorities trying to serve the arrest warrant. Police say these individuals were armed with bolos. They are now facing charges of obstruction of justice, illegal possession of bladed weapons, and disobedience of lawful orders of persons in authority.
The Philippine National Police claims innocence amid criticisms over its operations to arrest religious leader Apollo Quiboloy. Over 100 policemen stormed the properties of Quiboloy in Davao Monday, which led to a scuffle with the pastor's supporters. The PNP said the deployment of more police forces was needed amid threats of resistance from Quiboloy.
Kailangan natin magdagdag ng puwersa kasi bago po ito ay nakikinig niya po, may mga pronouncement po si Pastor Quiboloy na hindi siya magpapahuli ng buhay at talagang may resistance. Kaya nagdagdag po tayo ng puwersa dahil to make sure na magiging mapayapa at maayos po yung paghahain po ng warrant of arrest dahil inaasahan nga po na natin na magkakaroon po ng resistance na siya namang pong nangyari.
The PNP mulls filing more cases against other Quiboloy supporters on top of the 3 charges it filed Friday. The camp of the pastor also gearing up for the brewing legal battle.
Pinag-aakalan po natin kung madadagdagan na pa po ito. Kung matatandaan niyo po ay doon naman po sa KOJC compound ay may mga nangyari din pong resistance. In fact, ay binatang kanon pa po yung ating mga police. So pinag-aakalan natin, sasampahan din po ba natin sila ng kasong obstruction. Bagamat ayaw nating lumala pa itong tensyon.
Quiboloy, who remains at large, is facing sexual abuse and trafficking cases in Davao and Pasig City courts. A woman is arrested by the Parañaque City Police, accused of scamming over 500 people. Jeff Caparas reports.
A suspected fraudster accused of scamming some 300 million pesos from hundreds of victims falls to authorities. The 26-year-old female suspect has been in hiding for 2 years. She was arrested in Tanza, Cavite last week following 2 months of surveillance operations. Like many investment scams, victims were promised high returns in a short amount of time.
More or less mga 300 to 500 personalities. Ang nag-invest, amounting almost 200 to 300 million. Ang tawag nila rito is pasalo, paluwagan. So, bibigay ka, let's see, a certain amount, like example, yun ang sabi ng suspect, ng kinausap ko. May 30 ka, within 10 days, or prior to that 10 days, gawin nilang 45,000.
According to Parañaque PNP, some of her victims were lured using through social media platforms, but most of them were neighbors of the suspect.
Kasi magandang ano niya, magpo-post siya ng kunyari 30k, kailangan ng 5 katao. Okay. Maraming nag-ano ka sa kanya, nag-PPM na pasalo ako, ganyan-ganyan.
Ano sinasabi? So yun sa'yo, anong sinalo mo, magkano?
30, tutubo ng 20. So magiging 50,000.
Pinangako sa iyo?
Pinangako sa amin yun. Siyempre, maraming balita dito na ganun nga daw, pumabilis po ang pera. Naingganyo kami, hindi ako nagdalawang isip nung nagkaroon ako ng pera, ibinigay ko.
One of the victims lost 1.8 million pesos which were supposed to be used for a family member's medical treatment.
Galit na galit ho ako kasi wala talaga siyang konsensya. Ang gusto ko sabihin, sana huli makonsensya ka. Yan na yung ano mo na napagdusahan mo yun.
Authorities again reminded the public to be vigilant and to avoid engaging in investments and other financial transactions through social media platforms.
Ang sabi ng suspect, mag-isa siya. But most of the victims that we talk regarding sa business and investment scam ng suspect ay buong pamilya. Dapat sa opisina ng transaction kasi it involves with thousands o lalo na millions. So pinaghirapan nyo yan. Hindi ganun kadali. Well, you must be alert and dapat, sabi ko nga, maging makumatsyag ka. What if? Magtanong ka. May kontrata ba yan?
The suspect who is among the most wanted person in Parañaque City is facing complaints of estafa. Other victims are encouraged to coordinate with police to bring charges against the suspect. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Armed Forces undeterred in performing its mandate as China's regulation to detain supposed foreign trespassers in the South China Sea takes effect today, June 15th. AFP's Public Affairs Chief Colonel Xerxes Trinidad insists Beijing's anti-trespassing policy undermines the rule of law and international norms. He adds the AFP will continue its maritime patrols over the West Philippine Sea, which China claims as its own. Under Beijing's controversial regulation, its Coast Guard can detain alleged trespassers entering Chinese waters for up to 60 days without trial. State-run insurer SSS flags five local firms for failing to remit the monthly contributions of their employees for at least 4 years. Jackie Pascual reports.
State-run pension fund Social Security System or SSS has issued a notice of violation to five businesses in Muntinlupa Friday. The companies include a management consultancy firm, an outpatient rehabilitation facility, a restaurant, and a solar panel installation firm. The agency said the five firms have failed to remit the monthly contributions of their employees, totaling to over 2 million pesos, including penalties. The employers are urged to respond within 2 weeks and pay up or avail of the condonation program.
If they fail to do so within 15 days, their account will be endorsed by the branch, by the account officer to our office for filing of complaint.
SSS said a creative design solutions company has not remitted the contributions of its five employees from 2018 to 2021 worth nearly 1 million pesos. Employees will be the ones who will be affected if their contributions have been subtracted from their salary but not remitted to SSS.
Pagka nagkasakit na walang at least 3 contributions prior sa pagkakasakit, nadi-deny po yung claim. Ganon din po sa loan, pagka hindi updated yung bayad sa loan at hindi updated ang contribution, hindi po nakaka-loan.
The operation is part of the Run After Contribution Evaders or RACE program. There have been over 250 such operations in Metro Manila this year so far, and officials asserted this initiative has been successful.
Dahil po sa ating RACE operations, we were able to collect almost 52.4 million sa mga financially distressed na mga employers natin na pwede natin silang bigyan ng option o pagkakataon na makapagbangon ulit.
SSS plans to hold more RACE operations this year as it reminds employers to regularly remit the contributions of employees. SSS President Rolando Macasait has said the target is to hit over 100 billion pesos in net income this year. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The U.S. military reportedly launched a secret anti-COVID vaccine campaign in the Philippines in an effort to combat China's growing influence in the country. A Reuters investigative report says the Pentagon's secret operation was launched in 2020. It was expanded beyond Southeast Asia before it was terminated in late 2021. The operation supposedly aimed to sow doubt about the safety and efficacy of the COVID jabs and other life-saving aid from China. The camp of President Biden and former U.S. President Donald Trump did not respond to Reuters for comment. The Philippines formally asks the United Nations to register its extended continental shelf in the western Palawan region in the West Philippine Sea. The Foreign Affairs Department said the submission is a declaration not only of Manila's maritime entitlements, but also of its commitment to international processes. It adds this will also help secure Manila's sovereign rights in maritime jurisdictions. This is the second time the Philippines has registered an ECS entitlement. In 2012, the UN Commission on the Limits of the Continental Shelf validates Manila's submission on the Philippine rise. The Chinese Embassy in Manila urges the Philippine government to ban offshore gaming operators, or POGOs. The embassy asserts POGOs are detrimental to both Philippine and Chinese interests, as well as China-Philippines relations. China adds they firmly oppose any accusation in connection with POGOs. The statement comes amid recent raids conducted by Philippine law enforcement agencies against several POGO hubs that yielded dozens of arrests and the discovery of illegal activities and items. Most of those arrested were Chinese citizens. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission set to file non-bailable criminal charges against suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go. Without giving further details, the interagency body said it has found evidence of Go's involvement in illegal POGOs in her town. A series of government raids and investigations showed Go used to do business with Chinese firms involved in illegal POGO operations in Bamban, Tarlac. Authorities are also looking into its possible link to Pampanga's biggest POGO hub, where evidence of torture and scam activities were uncovered. With an update on the Filipino crew members of a merchant ship attacked by Houthi rebels, all but one have been rescued today. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo joins us on the line with that story. Kat, go ahead.
Hi, Rika. 21 of the 22 Filipino seafarers aboard the MV Tudor, which was attacked by Houthi rebels in the Red Sea, have been rescued. That's according to the Department of Migrant Workers. According to Migrant Workers Secretary Hans Kakdak, Combined International Forces launched the rescue mission around 10 p.m. on June 14, but he declined to name which countries were involved in the extraction operation. Kakdak says the ship was adrift in the southern portion of the Red Sea. It was immobilized but stable. The 21 Filipino seafarers were extracted and then they were boarded into a security ship. Kakdak says as of the moment, he cannot disclose the location of the said security vessels and where it would actually bring the Filipino seafarers for security purposes. He says the lone Filipino seafarer who remains to be found was trapped in the engine room at the time when the vessel was attacked by drones from the Houthi rebels. He says the DMW and other allies are still searching for that Filipino worker. The DMW has already accompanied the family of the missing seafarer to its manning agency to ensure that the crew would receive proper assistance and compensation. He says they were assured that the agency and other authorities will not stop in locating the missing seafarer who they believe is just within the ship. Now, if we recall, Houthi rebels launched waterborne drones and missiles against MV Tudor, a Greek-owned and Liberian-flagged freighter, on June 12 while it was sailing off the coast of Yemen. MV Tudor is the third ship with Filipino crew members that have been attacked by Houthi rebels since November. In March, two Filipinos died from a Houthi rebel attack while 11 others were rescued. And up until now, around 17 Filipinos still remain hostage aboard the MV Galaxy. Rika.
Thank you so much, Katrina Domingo, reporting live. After a round of rollbacks, fuel prices are seen increasing next week. A liter of diesel is projected to be more expensive by as much as 1 peso and 80 centavos, while gasoline prices could see an increase of up to 90 centavos. As for kerosene, prices could increase by as much as 1 peso and 90 centavos. An LGBT plus advocate reiterates a passage of the SOGIESC equality bill does not equate to supposed special treatment for the community. Pantay and Pride Philippines national convener Vinca Liban says the bill does not require additional rights for the LGBT plus community. Instead, it breaks barriers and gives access to fair rights and opportunities.
Sa tingin po namin, ito ay tamang oras din no, na pag-usapan muli ang SOG Equality Bill, lalong-lalo na given the clamor, the increase in public clamor for it. We made history as one of the largest, if not the largest, Pride celebration in Southeast Asia. And this year, we aim to double that. So ang Pride po this year will be a show of force of the community and a love letter to our national leaders na sana ay mapakinggan.
Meanwhile, another LGBT plus group, Metro Manila Pride, announced it will not hold a Pride March this year. The nonprofit organization will instead lead various actions and events for Pride Month.